Hello, you're welcome to this amazing, infatigable television program entitled The Moment of Change. God has sent me to this generation to bring changes to every nook and crannies of the world entirely. As you begin to stay with me in this powerful program, Jesus Christ is going to change you from the inside to the outside. I got that word from God. The moment of change is from a Greek word which means metamorpho. It means to change from the inside to the outside. And God sent me to you that as you begin to watch me from now on, you are going to change for the better. God bless you.
Thank you. your word.
Lord, as your word comes forth, and as the Holy Spirit gives utterance, I command the flesh to go down, down, down deep. And the Holy Spirit to rise and rise. In the name of Jesus. If you hear me, say amen. I have titled my message today, The Beauty of Resurrection Power. Praise the Lord. It might have been ugly that Jesus died, but there is beauty out of it. Are you hearing me? I said there is beauty out of the resurrection. There is beauty out of the dead. And Jesus Christ, since he died, he has given us beautiful ashes. I say he has given us beautiful arches. Yeah. I say he has given us beautiful arches. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says in Isaiah 61 verse 3, he says there is beauty for arches. There is beauty for arches. You are supposed to be crying. You are supposed in your own tribulation and falling down, dead by now. But see, Jesus died for you, he died for me, he has given us victory. And we have beauty and cause to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. The devil is a liar. Are you hearing me? The devil was happy that he died. Little did he know that somehow, I said somehow, 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 Jesus is rising again.
Yeah.
Little did he know that Jesus is going to rise. Little did he know that Jesus is going to rise. And he did he rise?
Yeah.
Did he rise again?
Yeah.
Some time ago in America, there was a man. His name is called D. Lawrence. He said some time ago Jesus died, that was what people said. He said, look, I am going to do something like that in my time. And the people said, okay, I'm going to watch you and I'm going to rise again. And the newsman, the cameraman began to watch. I said, let's see this man who want to imitate Jesus. And most of the devil said they began to, you know, the man make agreement with the devil. Please, devil, help me. So on the third day I will rise again. Let them see. And they called the doctor confirmed him dead. Are you hearing me? And they buried the man. D. Lawrence in America. Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible and the story goes that, you know, on the third day that the man said, thunder blast the grave to pieces. Are you hearing me? Thunder blast every bones of the man was scattered everywhere. I said, Jesus is risen.
Yeah.
I said, Jesus is risen.
Yeah.
My Jesus is incomparable.
Yeah.
Come with me in this hour to Mark chapter 16, verse 1 to 10. Hallelujah. Mark 16, verse 1 to 10. I am so glad that I'm a child of God. Every day I celebrate the victory and the resurrection of Christ. It's not only on the Easter period, but every day of my life I am choosing to celebrate the victory and the celebration of Jesus Christ. If you hear me, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Mark 16 from verse 1 to 10. Verse 1. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome, bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb. And they asked each other, who will roll away from the entrance? Who will roll away from the entrance? Who will roll away the stone from the entrance of the tomb? Praise the Lord. Verse 4. But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. I said the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away.
Amen.
affliction of sickness, which was so large, and the enemy established in your life or in your family or any kind of relations, and they run away today, this hour. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I am here to prophesy unto you that every stone this hour there shall be a resurrection. In the name of Jesus. Where are we now? Verse 5. I read from the King James Version. I'll be reading from the American Version. An entry, verse 4. And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. An entry into the sepulcher, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted. And he said unto them, be not affrighted. Ye see Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. Verse 7. But go your way. Tell his disciples and Peter that he goeth before you into Galilee. Yea, shall ye see him as he said unto you. And they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. Now when Jesus was risen early, the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, and out of whom he had cast seven devils. Verse 10. And she went and told them that had been with him. Who had been with him? The disciples. As they mourned and wept, they were still mourning and weeping. Are you hearing me? Praise the Lord. The resurrection power. The beauty of resurrection. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When I searched through my archives and through some Bibles, you know, memories and Bible theories and so many archaeology books, I found out that resurrection simply means the rising of Jesus Christ from death after crucifixion. Are you hearing me? After burial and crucifixion. The rising up of Jesus Christ from the grave, from the dead. Amen?
Amen.
After death and burial and crucifixion. Is that what I'm taking note of? That is what? Resurrection. Resurrection. And how do we know that Jesus Christ has risen from the grave? Because the Bible says so. It is not the Holy Testament, only the New Testament that told us about the risen of Christ. The Old Testament has before informed us that Jesus Christ was going to rise again from the dead. It is written in the Old Testament. Anything you ever see in the New Testament, everything will be prophesied before in the Old Testament. And another resurrection, the meaning of resurrection, is the rising again of the dead at the last judgment. The rising again of the dead persons at the last judgment. Whether unbelievers, whether Christians. That is another explanation. And the third explanation of resurrection. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We are discussing resurrection power. But you have to know the difference between resurrection and somebody who died and didn't rise again. Revival from inactivity and disuse.